Okay. All right, cup. Cup. Good, Bobez.
Woo!
Good dogs. This is the part of the tour if anyone would like to go in for a quick dip.
Excellent.
Yeah, we do have spare cozzies. So I've been in there a couple of times. Very cold.
Yeah.
And as you're probably going to discover, Zach, water never gets warm in Canada.
No, even in summer.
Yeah, it is.
Freezing.
Yeah. Every year, in the summer, I'm a canoe instructor and lead like canoeing trips and everything.
Mm-hmm.
I lead a canoeing course, and it's on the May long weekend, and I wish it was on other weekends, but it's always on this weekend every year. And May long weekend is notorious for it to snow.
Oh.
Yeah, it's like meant to be spring going on summer, but it snows every year.
Every single time you do it.
Every single time I'm out on the river for 3 days, it's just snowing. Yeah, and when friends are like, oh, I'm going camping on the long weekend, I'm like, have fun with that, and they always regret it and pack up after the first day. Good dogs! Yeah, I've seen snow in every month here.
Wow.
Yeah.
It never really hit summer then.
Yeah, it does, it just has that freak storm, like I've had, whoa! The only time I have had it snow in August, it was the very end of August, but it's still like, the day before it was 30 degrees and sunny, and then that night it snowed half a foot.
Wow.
And then the next day it all melted because it was 25 degrees again. Alright, hike up!
Hike up!
That is a fresh one!
Yeah. It tends to smell 10 times worse because of the cold.
Yeah. Good puppies! Come on! Good dogs! Fingers crossed, there's no forecast for it, but the forecast is really right. It's such a hard area for I feel sorry for the meteorologists in this area, because it's quite difficult. Like, sometimes they say it's going to be like that freak storm that I had in August that time, like they were calling for another 20 degree day, and it was that day, but if you just lean to the right here, all our dogs on there. The left are working a lot harder. Actually, Flint is the one making it. He's the orange one. Yeah, he's pulling. He'll be pulling twice as hard as any dog on this team.
Yeah, well, it's, I don't know. They should just do away with the meteorologists.
Yeah.
Say,
roll a dice.
You want to know what the weather is? Go and look outside.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Alberta has there's a place in Alberta that has the record for the largest temperature change in history ever recorded.
Wow.
And, because they have you heard of what Chinooks are? So, like, it's a warm wind that comes through, and temperature can dramatically change, like, 30 degrees in a day kind of thing, like,
wow.
Yeah, this was in Pincher Creek, and this was just a freak occurrence. It went from minus 10 to 12.8 degrees, so it changed 22.8 degrees Celsius in a space of 1 hour.
That's crazy.
Yeah, so it just quickly, like, it went from being cold, and then within an hour, it was... Like, everyone, no one knew what to do. Because it was in the middle of winter as well. Good dogs! Come, pups, come on! Good boy there, Red.
Come on!
Goodbye there, car. Good girl, little torch. Good puppies.
She's very small.
Yes, so is her sister Blackie up in lead. The black one.
It's almost like a fox from back here.
Yeah, they're miniature Siberian. They're absolutely tiny.
Amazing. Tough advert.
Oh, yes. Mate, give her.
Job here.
Oh, it's hard.
Beautiful.
Difficult, yeah. I don't know how I get myself out of bed.
Yeah.
There definitely are the perks to every job, and also like the downs, like having to chip away at frozen poo when it is minus 30,
yeah,
only with a headlamp and everything. Yeah. But all jobs have that.
It pays off, yeah.
And like we do have very long hours, and like quite often we'll be working 6 days a week.
Yeah.
And so like during the Christmas period, it'll be 5 or even 6 days a week, 14 hour days.
Very rewarding working with these animals.
Yeah.
Right? It's so beautiful.
Yeah.
Such a gorgeous place.
Yeah, like when I looked, I didn't even know you could do this as a job, but when I saw it in the paper, I'm like, you can do that? And because I was really wanting to look for something, I didn't want to do the whole, even though like it would be fun and everything, I just didn't want to work at a ski resort.
Yeah.
Because I'd been here for like half a year prior, and I'm like, I reckon there's other jobs out there, better way to see, and like, yeah, and I saw this and I'm like, whoa,
so
perfect.
So what was the requirements for doing this?
I've had previous guiding experience.
Okay.
If you don't have your first aid, they require you to get it, but
okay.
I have my 40-hour, like, wilderness first responder first aid.
Okay, great.
And it's just basically if you're enthusiastic, fit, and willing to chip away at frozen poo, and, like, at the start they make it sound like, exactly, like, they put you through the ringer just because, so then...
They know what they can expect.
Exactly, yeah.
That's fair enough.
Yeah. Like, I remember with the interview, Jeremy was like, your hands are always going to be cold. I've done this since I was 3 years old and I've still got cold hands.
So they put the fear in.
Yeah, exactly. And then if you're fine after that, you don't change your face. If anything, you get a bigger grin on your face and they're like, all right, this guy's going to be all right. Good dogs. Come, puppies. Old team parking boat. Come on there, Blackie. Good girl. Good dogs. And yeah, so the actual spray lake is the lake that's on the other side of this dam.
Okay, right.
Yeah, and it used to just be like 50 or 60 small little lakes, but since they dammed it, it's one big lake. And lots of the dams and like this canal is man-made, of course. Like lots of the different water reservoirs and dams around this area were actually, in like in Kananaskis country, were actually built by, it was during World War II. Lots of them were German officers that were captured and brought over here. And they were actually, after the war ended, they were given, because they were treated very equally and very good and everything, and after the war and everything, they were actually given the option on staying and becoming citizens.
Okay.
Yeah. Good puppies! Come on! Old team's on the service road. Come on there, pups, come on! How are you doing in there, Andy?
Fantastic, fantastic. I'm glad I come out today.
Yeah.
It's been really good.
Stunning.
The hands a bit chilly?
No, I actually just went boarding yesterday and had a bit of a cough